soccer match. Look, Nina's arriving. Hello, Nina.
Hey!
What's that? Wow, a soccer match! Wow, Pocoyo, you are a champion! Whoa! Here's Ellie. Amazing! Pato springs into action. He shoots and... goal! 5-0. You are true champions. It seems that Nina wants to play on your team. Oops.
Our team is complete.
Nina, I think that Pocoyo, Pato and Ellie don't need anyone else on the team.
Nina, fullboy!
Nina says that she'll form her own team. Poor Nina. She thinks she's bad at soccer. Hey! It looks like Roberto will be her coach. Take it easy, Nina. Pay attention. Paint the fence. Very good. Now, add wax, polish the wax. Very good. Now, the crane. Excellent. That's it. Very good. Are you ready? Whoa, Nina!
Whoa.
You're ready to play! You should create your own team now! Caterpillar, Nina wants you to join her team to defeat Pocoyo! Great! Wonderful! You're already a team!
Let's play!
And here's the referee! The match has begun! Nina runs with the ball. She dribbles it, but Pato intercepts the pass. Nina is trying to get the ball back. Ouch! Yellow card! Pato runs with the ball. He dribbles his rivals. No one can stop him! He passes the ball to Ellie, who controls the ball. She shoots! And the ball hits the post and gets stuck there! Roberto clears the ball! Alien jumps! Oh! Yellow card! Sleepy Bird heads the ball and... red card? Angry Alien argues with the referee! It's getting ugly out there, and he also gets a red card! And... penalty? Well, now the game depends on Caterpillar! She... She abandons the stadium, leaving the goal unprotected. Oh, looks good for Pocoyo's team. Nina is alone, trying to stop the ball. Pocoyo is ready. He shoots! Ball rebounds and goes to goal! Go, 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 go! Terrific! Nina and her team are the... Wait a second, something's going on. The trophy! Congratulations to the winners! And hooray for all the friends! Hello, everyone.
Hi.
That looks like a fun game of football you're playing. What a great goal! Hello, Nina.
Hey, Dad.
Hello, Roberto. Would you like to play football too? What's that? You have a much more fun game at home? Mm-hmm. More fun than football? Nina wonders if you'd like to try her game. Why don't you run and get your game, Nina? Nina was wondering if you'd please mind her pet robot until she returns. Great idea, Pato. Roberto can be goalie till Nina returns. Roberto, you must stop the ball. Oh dear. Are you all right? Oh my. Roberto looks like a toaster. He is a toaster. We'll be right back.
Oh dear. Are you all right? Now you're a robot vacuum. Well, that's handy. What with all this toast lying around. Caterpillar, baby bird, watch out! Pocoyo, phew! You've saved Caterpillar and baby bird. Very good. Roberto, be careful! Huh. It turns out you're a wonderful dancer. Oh no! He's out of control! You have to stop him! Nina! Quick! No one can shut Roberto down! You must know a way! Nina brought something for you all to play with. What fun! Great shot! Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Nina. I see you're playing tennis. Well done, Pocoyo! You scored a point! And a point for Nina! Hello, Pato. What's the matter? Those points don't count? But why, Pato? Oh, I see. They're not using the right ball. A basketball? Are you quite sure, Pato?
Brilliant point for Pato. What now, Ellie? That point didn't count either. The ball missed the goalposts, but what goalposts?
Line?
Ellie's foot stepped on the line. What line? Go, Pato! You really want to score, don't you? Roller skates? Why, there's another new rule. Time's up! This is all so silly! And all just to score a single point. Well, who cares if anyone scores? The most important thing is to have fun playing sports, isn't it? Oh, my. Well, goodbye.
Hello, Pato. Is that a racket? And a ball? What are you going to do with that?
Tennis!
What fun! It looks as if Caterpillar wants to play tennis too. Ellie says you're a little small to play tennis. And the winner is... Pato!
Pocoyo's Fairy Tales.
Hello, Pocoyo. What's that?
Story!
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo has a story for you. Once upon a time, there was a dinosaur who wanted to go to the Olympics. So his friend the ant helped him train. He had to run. And swim. And bike. dinosaur got very tired. But the ant said he had to keep going. So he had to run and swim and bike some more.
Oh.
And then he won. The end. Ah, can you tell me what Ellie's holding?
It's a racket.
Yes, it's a racket. Fantastic. Can you tell me what that is?
It's a ball.
Ball.
Look out, caterpillar! Oh! Pato wins again! Shape Shuffle. A triangle.
Triangle.
A rectangle.
Rectangle.
An oval.
Oval.
Triangle, rectangle, oval. What's this, Pocoyo?
Submarine.
I see. You've made a submarine with triangles, ovals, and rectangles.
Robot.
A robot. Can you tell me the names of the shapes? What are these?
Triangles.
And these?
Rectangles.
Rectangles.
And these?
Ovals.
Ovals.
Wonderful. Triangle, rectangle, oval. That was an exciting game. Who did that? Caterpillar? Oh my goodness! Look at this! Caterpillar wins! I guess you don't have to be big to be a winner.
Tennis, I love this game. I hit the ball, I win a point using my racket. Tennis is a funny game. I hit the ball, I win a point. Let's play again. My racket. Tennis is a funny game. I hit the ball, I win a point because I love this game.
Fabulous.
Hello, Ellie. Sorry. It seems Ellie is playing golf. She has her golf club and her golf ball. And there's the hole. Can you tell Pocoyo what game Ellie is playing?
Golf! Playing golf. I play.
Oh dear. And now, a quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Hello, Pocoyo. A golf bag? A green? Now, Pocoyo.
Green. Bye. Green!
Well, good night. Can you tell Pocoyo what that is? And now, can you tell Pocoyo what that is?
A golf ball!
It's a golf ball!
Well done, Ellie! It's very close to the hole. Oops! Pocoyo. You're right, Ellie. That wasn't nice.
Wheel of Colors. Welcome to the show. Today's color is pink. All right, your job is to find something pink. Go!
Something pink.
Right, let's see your pictures. A pink ball, a pink box, and a pink flower. Good job! Now keep looking. A pink door, perfect. A pink glass, beautiful. And this, do you know what it is? Right! A pink alien! Hooray for pink!
Sorry.
Play again?
Yes, let's play again. Good shot, Ellie. Oh dear. Well, Ellie is going to help you, Pocoyo. Ooh. Ah! Wow! The ball went in the hole! Hooray! What a great game!
I have a golf bag with golf clubs inside. You see the flag far away.
We're at the golf course, we're going to play. Now try what I'm going to say. Using the golf club, you then hit the golf ball and make it fly into the hole.
Hello, everyone. What did I say?
1, 2, 3.
Oh, I see. It's a game. You're playing hide and seek.
8, 9, 10.
Pocoyo, you do know what to do now, don't you? No, you don't hide. Your friends hide and you look for them.
I know. Lula, yay!
Oh, Pocoyo.
I found, yay!
Yes, but Lula isn't playing the game.
Sleepy Bird, yay!
Sleepy Bird isn't playing hide and seek either. You need to find Ellie, Pato and Baby Bird. Cheer up, they should be easy to find. Oh dear.
Professor Otto.
Hello, class. Now pay attention. Professor Pato is going to tell us about positions. This is a box. And this is a ball. The ball is out of the box. Out of. Now the ball is in the box. In. Now the ball is behind the box. Behind. And now it's in front of the box. In front of. Baby Bird wants to say something. Phew! Now we've learned all about positions. Thank you, Professor Pato.
Lesson approved by Professor Pato.
Pocoyo is coming. Hide, hide. Behind the tree, quick. Don't give up, Pocoyo. Keep looking. Can you tell Pocoyo where Ellie is hiding?
Behind you.
She's hiding behind the tree.
Ellie, yay!
You found her. Good job. Pato, hide! In the box, good idea. Can you tell Pocoyo where Pato is hiding?
Behind you!
Behind you in the box!
Pato! Yay!
Well done!
Animals, dots to dot.
Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're thinking about that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? Then let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Let's finish the picture. Can you tell Pocoyo what that is?
It's a crocodile!
Crocodile!
Yes! It's a crocodile! Oh my! Pocoyo's coming! Hide! Ah, Pocoyo, do you want us to help you find baby bird?
No, I find.
I see, you want to find baby bird all by yourself. All right, go ahead.
Baby bird, yeah!
Well done! Hey, where did he go? Found them all! Hooray for hide and seek!
Hide, seek. Where is he now?
He's in the box.
Where is he now? Where is he now?
He's in front of the stone.
Where is he now?
He's behind the stone.
Where is he now?
He's in the box.
Where is he now?
He's out of the box.
Where is he now?
He's behind the stone.
Where is he now?
Well, hello, Ellie. What have you got there? A bicycle. How wonderful.
Wait!
Huh, look at those wheels. What is that?
Scooter.
A scooter. And what a lovely scooter it is. Did you see that? Pato wants to go for a ride too. A skateboard? Terrific! Oh, what fun! And now, a quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Hello, Pocoyo. A bus. Train. Now, Pocoyo.
Train. Bye.
Train!
Well, good night. Caterpillar, look out! Can you tell Caterpillar what Ellie is riding?
A bicycle!
A bicycle!
Right, a bicycle! And what is Pocoyo riding?
A scooter!
It's a scooter!
A scooter! Right! And what is Pato riding?
Skateboard!
It's a skateboard!
A skateboard! Right! Caterpillar says she wants to ride too. And now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, walk backwards. Walking backwards is fun. Whoops. Fred says, roll. Come on. Roll on the floor. Fred says, hop. That's it. Hop on one foot. Well done. Fred says, that's all. Aren't you forgetting something, Caterpillar? Exactly. Oh dear, that skateboard is too big. That scooter is too big too. That bicycle is way too big. Oh. Oh, poor Caterpillar. Everything is too big for her. You have an idea? Look! Pato's giving Caterpillar a ride on his skateboard. And Ellie's giving Caterpillar a ride on her bicycle. Now Pocoyo's giving her a ride on his scooter. Wow! Riding with friends looks fun!
If you can ride a bicycle, a scooter or a skateboard, then you can go anywhere. Doesn't matter if it's near, doesn't matter if it's far. You can ride a bicycle, a scooter or a skateboard. Then you can go anywhere. Doesn't matter if it's near, doesn't matter if it's far.
Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Sorry. Hello? What are you doing in that boat?
Fish!
Ah, I see. You're fishing.
Net!
You have a fishing net and a fishing rod.
Caterpillar!
And Caterpillar is going to help. Wonderful. Now we just have to wait.
Professor Toto.
Now, class, pay attention. Professor Pato says, this is a ship. A ship. This is a boat. A boat. And this is a lighthouse. A lighthouse. Baby bird, can you tell us what that is? Can you tell baby bird what that is?
It's a lighthouse!
Hmm. It looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say.
Lighthouse!
Wonderful! Now we know about ships, boats and lighthouses. Thank you, Professor Pato!
Lesson approved by Professor Pato.
Can you tell Caterpillar what that is? That's right, it's a fish. Can you tell the fish what that is?
A net.
It's a fishing net.
Can you tell the fish what that is?
A fishing rod.
It's a fishing rod.
Look, boys. Pato's got something.
Pato, fish.
A boot? A wheel? Fishing can be very hard. Number menu!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ah, time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 10 strawberries. Very good.
10 strawberries.
10 strawberries. Oh dear. Well, how about 10 peas instead?
10 peas.
10 peas. Ah, poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
10 hearts.
That's right. 10. Oh dear, you're not catching many fish. Oh, it's a big one! A very big one! Now, Pato and Pocoyo, you're not really angry, are you? After all, it was pretty funny.
Hooray for fishing! And hooray for new friend!
I'm in a boat, I am fishing with my fishing rod. To catch a fish, I am using my net.
Using my net.
Rod. Net. Fish. Ship. Boat. Lighthouse.
I'm in a boat. I am fishing with my fishing rod. Catch a fish, I am using my net.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Hello, Pato. Hello, Ellie. And what are our little friends up to today? Did you hear that? Oh, look! It's our friend Octopus. Hello, Octopus. Oh, and look what he's got with him. Can any of you tell Pocoyo, Pato and Ellie what Octopus is carrying?
A bat and a ball!
Yes, he's got a bat and ball with him. And it looks like Octopus has a great idea. Everyone can play bat and ball. Octopus is all set to play. Who's going to bat? Ah, it looks like Pato has the first turn, Pocoyo. Oh, don't worry, Pocoyo. Everyone will have a turn to bat the ball. Ellie, you'll have to wait for your go, too. Poor Pato. Now, what can that be? It's Octopus! He's winding up and... Wait! I think it is! Yes! It's the Whipping Windmill Whopper! Well, that's one way to hit the ball, Pato. Great job, Pocoyo. Bringing the ball back is a very important job, especially when we only have one ball. It looks like Ellie is going to bat now. After all, she was waiting too, remember? But don't worry, Pocoyo. You'll be next. Oh, what a hit! I knew she'd work out how to do it sooner or later. It's going! It still seems to be going! Now, where's it gone? Why, it's Sleepy Bird. Maybe she's seen the ball. Well, that's closer, Pocoyo. But, can all of you help Pocoyo again? Is that his ball?
No!
It's an egg, Pocoyo!
Well, that's odd. A snowman and some snowballs. I wonder whose team he's on. Well, do you see the ball anywhere, Pocoyo? Wait, do you hear that? What's that sound? What was that? What happened? I think the ball just came down. Did you see it, Pocoyo? What about all of you? Did any of you see where the ball landed?
By the snowman!
You've got it! It's that one. Great job, Pocoyo.
Boring.
And now, at last, it's Pocoyo's turn to bat. Remember, Pocoyo, keep your eye on the ball. a hit! Hooray for Pocoyo and hooray for having your turn! Right, let's go and get that ball now. Bye! See you soon! Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I say. Yes. What or who is that? Can any of you tell Pocoyo who it is?
It's Ellie.
But what is she doing? Wow, look at that! I do believe Ellie is playing a round of golf! Now, Pocoyo, just hold your horses. Ellie is going to show you how to play.
Pocoyo, play! Pocoyo, play! Play, 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 play!
Pocoyo, why don't you watch carefully and see how Ellie does it? Oh, Pocoyo.
Pocoyo knows.
Really, Pocoyo? However are you going to learn how to play golf now that Ellie's gone? Whoops-a-daisy!
Pocoyo knows!
It's not so easy after all, is it?
No! Pocoyo knows!
Still not working, eh? A trumpet? If you asked Ellie, I'm sure she'd... A watering can? Oh dear, Ellie. Pocoyo really does need your help. Oh, you've had another idea. Would you like to learn how to play golf, Pocoyo? Well, I think there is someone who could help you. In fact, she offered to show you before. Do you know who I mean, Pocoyo?
show Pocoyo.
Yay!
Now, watch carefully, Pocoyo. See how Ellie does it. Well, I think you're ready to have a go then. Wait, Pocoyo. Oh dear. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what he's doing wrong?
It's upside down.
Yes, you did it, Pocoyo. Hooray for Pocoyo and hooray for watching and learning. Bye-bye. See you soon. Why, hello, Pocoyo. Look at that. What's Ellie doing? Can any of you tell Pocoyo what Ellie is doing? Yes, Ellie is juggling, Pocoyo. Looks like great fun, doesn't it, Pocoyo?
Pocoyo, juggle.
Oh, dear. Well, it does take a long time to learn to juggle, Pocoyo. Ellie, how did you learn to do that? I think she's going to show you. So Octopus is the one who taught Ellie to juggle. Come on, Pocoyo, don't be shy. Now, I know juggling is very difficult, Octopus, but Pocoyo has really set his heart on having a go. Oh, you're copying. Very clever. Pocoyo, you are lucky. Octopus is going to teach you.
Pocoyo juggle.
That's interesting. I think Octopus wants you to bounce, Pocoyo. Oh, very good. I think Octopus wants you to curl yourself up into a ball, Pocoyo. Well, look at it this way, Pocoyo. You certainly are getting good at... Well, whatever it is that you're doing.
Pocoyo juggle.
Oh, I wonder what that's for. It seems that octopus was just a little hot. Well, how interesting. Octopus now wants you to open and close the umbrella. I wonder what he has in mind. Very good, Pocoyo. What's this? It looks like Ellie and Octopus are going to put on a show. Oh, I think Octopus would like you to help with the show, Pocoyo. Yes, you!
Join in!
I see why Octopus made Pocoyo practice like that. You're a bit too young to juggle, Pocoyo, but not too young to be juggled. You were able to join in after all and be the star of the show. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Warming up. Pato, Pocoyo, and Ellie. All right then. Ladies and gentlemen, it brings me great pleasure to announce the first ever race of the Pocoyo-lympics. So, with no further ado, let's meet the runners. First, the boy in blue, Pocoyo! Next up, he's quick, and he says, quack! It's Pato! And finally, it's the pink lady herself, Ellie! Sorry, Ellie. And now the runners are preparing for the start of the race. All right then, is everybody ready? Then on your marks, get set, go! Oh, that's a surprise. It's a running round in circles race. Look at them go. I don't think I've ever seen a race like this before. Who's going to keep going the longest? Oh, and that's Ellie out of the running. Now, who's going to win? Ooh, watch out! Bad luck, Pocoyo!
Bravo, everyone! What splendid running! So, can any of you tell Pocoyo and Pato and Ellie who won the race?
Pato!
Pato is the winner!
Pato, congratulations. You won the race. What is it, Pato? Oh, yes, your prize. Well, Oh, that's a fantastic prize. Now, what competition could we have next? Any ideas?
Tidy up contest.
Toys in box. Toys in box.
Oh, I say, what a good idea, Pocoyo.
And the next competition is...
Tidy up quick.
Exactly. Ready? On your marks. Get set. Go! Well done, Ellie.
I'm sure there's got to be something you're the very best at. In fact, I know just what the last contest should be. It's going to be a giggling contest.
Giggle?
Ah, and here's Octopus now. Who do you think is giggling the loudest and the longest and the giggliest? Pocoyo's the winner! You see, Pocoyo? You don't have to be best at everything because everybody is good at something. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye! See you soon! Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Oops, oh, dear. Careful. That stuff's slippery, you know. Can you tell Pocoyo the name of that frozen slippery stuff?
It's ice.
Yes, it's ice. Pato is skating on the ice. Why not give it a try, Pocoyo? Beautiful! Hey, you're a natural. These two fine skaters displaying excellent form today. Really astonishing style. Here's a lift and... Oh, tremendously tricky helicopter-like move from Pato, followed by a flawless landing. Both skaters demonstrating exceptional style and grace. Wow, perfect finish. We're really seeing two pros right at the top of their game. But we'll have to wait and see what the judges have to say. Baby Spider, give them a 10. And a 10 from Baby Bird. And Caterpillar, a 1. Ah, a 10. A perfect score for these two fine skaters. And here's someone we're all waiting to see. Ellie, surely one of the most graceful dancers. Athletic, ladylike, elephantine. Surely a winning combination. And here she goes. Lovely! A study in... Oh, dear. Ellie, are you all right? Ah, and here come Pocoyo and Pato to help Ellie to her feet. Hello, Fred. What's that? You're going to be dancing with a partner? Well, who is it? A saw? What can he be up to? It's whale! You know, normally you don't see a whale taking part in skating competitions. This is really something. Fantastic height on this! And now for the catch. This is going to be spectacular. Let's see what the judges have to say. A 10 from Baby Spider. Baby Bird still hard at work. The pressure on these judges has to be extraordinary. What about you, Caterpillar? 10 from Caterpillar. So, it's all up to Baby Bird. Looks like he's decided. He gives the performance a daisy wearing a hat and driving a car. Here's Ellie again. Looks like she could do with some encouragement to get her back on the ice. Can you help me to tell her to try again?
Try again!
You can do it!
Ah, here she goes. Very good. And... stunning! Oh, dear. Oh, Pato once again squashed entirely flat. But he's right back on his feet. That is one plucky duck. But it looks like Ellie doesn't want to play anymore. Perhaps she would do better if someone who's really good at skating helped her. Can you tell Pocoyo and Pato who could help Ellie?
Pocoyo and Pato!
Yes, that's a great idea. Help her! What's this? Ah, looks like Ellie has got a little help from her friends. Excellent. I do believe you're getting the hang of it, Ellie. Good for you. Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for Pato! And Ellie, where did she go? Wow, just look at that! This is the kind of performance you see once in a lifetime. All she needed was a little help getting started. Stunning! A dazzling display from this pink pachyderm. But let's go to the judges. And it's... 3 tens! A perfect score! And 10s from the other competitors! Wow! Hooray for Ellie! Hooray for helping friends! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Look, there's Pato and Pocoyo. Hello there, Pocoyo. Hello, Pato.
Hello!
What's that they've got? Do any of you know what it is?
A ball!
It's a ball!
Yes, a ball. And it's a very nice ball. So red and bouncy. Is it a new one? I think Baby Bird rather likes the ball too.
Hello, baby bird. Ah, there's nothing quite like a new ball, is there? Pocoyo, Pato, I believe Baby Bird would like to play with you. Poor Baby Bird. Pocoyo and Pato think he's too little to play with their ball. Oh dear. What are you going to do now, Pocoyo? Gone now. Can any of you tell Pato and Pocoyo where Baby Bird is?
Up in the tree!
Oh no! He's flying away! However will you get your ball back now? Good thinking, Pocoyo, the vamoosh. Pocoyo. Oh dear. Don't cry, baby bird. Pocoyo and Pato. What should Pocoyo and Pato do to make Baby Bird feel happy again?
Let him play!
Aww. are, you see. There's something even better than a new ball. Making a friend feel happy. Oh, well, looks like all three of them are having a ball now. Ah, hooray for Pocoyo. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, baby bird. And hello, Pocoyo. Wow, look at that! Let's all clap. What's that, baby bird? You say that's the best ball bouncing you've ever seen in your whole life. Well, that's quite a compliment. You say that's the most amazing construction you've ever seen. Well, it's certainly a nice wall, but better than the pyramids in Egypt. Well, if you say so, baby bird. What's this? Ah, baby bird obviously thinks your drawing is something special, Pocoyo. Well, yes, of course it's art. But better than the Mona Lisa? Well, what's that? A red carpet? Goodness! Well, I suppose nothing less will do for Baby Bird's hero.
Yay!
Hello, Pato. Says you've played enough, Pato. It's his turn now. Hello, Ellie. Ah, now this is fun. Baby Bird says pushing Pocoyo is his job, Ellie. Pocoyo says he's tired, Baby Bird. He'll see you later. Oh, baby bird. Hello. Bothering Pocoyo?
Baby Bird! Baby Bird!
You told Baby Bird to go away.
Do you really want to see him again? You'll have to look through this telescope.
Sad.
Can any of you tell Pocoyo what he did that made Baby Bird sad?
He made him go away!
Said go away!
That's right. After all, he only wanted to be your friend, Pocoyo. There, there, Baby Bird. Pocoyo didn't mean it. He just needed to be by himself for a while. What's this? An invitation. Someone wants you to come to a party, Baby Bird.
Sorry.
That was a nice apology, Pocoyo. What's that? You say that was the greatest apology ever?
Hooray for Pocoyo and hooray for Baby Bird. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Pocoyo and Lula are going to the beach today. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Lula, too.
Hi.
That's right, a day at the beach. They have a picnic lunch and a beach umbrella and... Pocoyo, where are you going? That's not the way to the beach. Ah, good idea, Pocoyo. A ball. A round, orange, little ball. What a good thing to take with us.
Round?
Yes, round, like a circle. Very good, Pocoyo. Well, I'm sure Lula will love to play fetch with it in the sand. Now, we'd better get... Pocoyo, the beach is, not that way either. Oh, dear. There you are. Now, where is that ball? Do you see it, Pocoyo? Which one is it? Can any of you tell Pocoyo which one is his ball?
The round one!
It's round!
Round!
That's right, Pocoyo. Your ball is round. Now we can go to the beach. Our friend Pato seems to be having fun. Very nice, Pato. But, oh, look out! Phew, that was close, wasn't it, Pato? Uh-oh, here comes Lula. Oh, poor Pato, and after he worked so hard. Pato, I think Pocoyo's ball is somewhere in here. Can you help?
Round.
Yes, Pato's right. Everything here seems to be round. But wasn't there something else about your ball, Pocoyo? Can any of you tell Pocoyo which one is his ball? Oh, Lula sees it too. Oh, no, not again. Sorry about that, Pato. Oh, juggling! How clever! Look out! Oh, dear. Hello, Ellie. This looks a bit more difficult, doesn't it? Perhaps you should tell Ellie what your ball looks like.
Rounds. Orange.
No, that's not it. What else did we say about the ball? It's round, it's orange, and... Can any of you help Pocoyo work out which one it is?
It's little!
Little!
Good thinking. So, now that you've got your ball, do you think we can finally go to the beach? I see. Well, I suppose we got here after all. Hooray for Pocoyo! All in all, it's a lovely day for Pocoyo. And for me too, for that matter.
Bye-bye.
Bye. See you soon. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Now, let me guess. You're going to play catch.
Pato, play!
No. Oh, come on, Pato, it's fun. Looks like Pato really doesn't want to play catch. Well, what do you want to do, Pato? I see the seesaw. Well, maybe you could play ball with Pocoyo and go on the seesaw afterwards. Oh, you'll only play on the seesaw? Oh, hi, Ellie.
Play?
Looks like Pocoyo's found someone to play with after all. Now, don't look so gloomy, Pato. You can go and play with them, you know. No. You're just going to sit and sulk, are you? That doesn't look like much fun by yourself. Can you tell Pato how many people it takes to play on the seesaw?
Two. You need two people.
Yeah, that's right. The thing about seesaws is that you really need a friend to get any fun out of them. What's that, Pato? You say you've got a friend? The perfect friend? Who? But that's just a machine. I see that button turns it on. Goodness! Pato! That machine made another you! It looks as if you really have found the perfect friend, Pato. Someone just like you. Oh dear, you two want to play with the same thing. Another Pato? What will you two play? This seems more... like it?
You're right. These Pattos didn't make such good friends after all. Maybe this one'll be perfect. Aha! Watering flowers, a favourite pursuit. That Pato likes watering as much as you do. A joke! Haha, wonderful! Oh, I suppose that Pato has heard your joke before, Pato. It seems this Pato wants to watch your other favourite channel. Another Pato? Oh dear, the Pato copy has copied himself! Pato, is this machine really helping you get what you want? You say those other Patos are selfish. They only want to play their way. Oh dear. Oh, perhaps this machine wasn't the best idea after all. Pocoyo, Ellie, Pato has a slight problem here. Can any of you tell Pocoyo and Ellie where to look to see the problem?
Behind you!
Look behind you!
Pato's everywhere! Oh, they're out of control! What can we do? Think. You've got an idea. Oh, do hurry. Oh, please hurry. Quick. The machine, of course. Oh, dear. Do you think Pocoyo should press the button to turn the machine off?
Yes, push the button.
Well, that's a relief.
Play?
Terrific! Hooray for friends! Hooray for being different to each other! What's this? Oh dear! Bye-bye! See you soon! Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Hey, look at Pato. Quick, Pocoyo, behind you. What is Pato doing? I don't think Pocoyo knows. I wonder, do any of you know what Pato is doing?
Skipping!
Yes, Pato is skipping with a skipping rope. I wonder who this is. Of course. Hello, Ellie. Ellie's got a skipping rope too.
Pocoyo?
Skipping rope.
Oh, I see. I think Pocoyo wants a skipping rope as well.
Thank you, Ellie.
Now you can all play skipping together. Now that's a good game. All follow Ellie. Are you sure you know how to skip with a rope, Pocoyo?
1, 2, 3.
Oh dear, it's not as easy as it looks, is it? I know, why don't you ask Ellie and Pato? I'm sure they'd show you how to skip with a rope. Well, if you're sure.
1, 2, 3.
Oops. Perhaps I'll count you in this time. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Pocoyo? The rope? Can you see where it's gone, Pocoyo? Oops! Sorry, sleepy bird. Poor Pocoyo. You really want to skip with a rope, don't you? You need some help. Who could help you learn to skip, Pocoyo? Who can he ask for help? Can any of you tell Pocoyo?
Ask Ellie and Pato.
That's a terrific idea. Why don't you ask Ellie and Pato, Pocoyo? I see. Now that is a good idea. If Ellie and Pato help by turning the rope, you can think clearly about trying to skip. Oh, they're not ready yet, Pocoyo. The rope needs to be turning for you to skip in it. Shall I count you in again? That's it. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Well done, Pocoyo. You did it. You can skip with a rope. You see, Pocoyo, there's nothing wrong with asking for help once in a while. Otherwise, you might just have to skip a lot of the fun. So ends another day with our friend Pocoyo. Well, maybe we'll just skip a bit more. Bye-bye. See you soon. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Hello, Pato. Ooh, what's that?
Scooter, scooter, scooter!
Whose is that lovely pink scooter?
Ellie's.
And I wonder what it's doing here. Perhaps she's forgotten it. What do you think? Should they take it back to her?
Yes! Take it to Ellie!
Take it to her!
Uh-oh. Work, Pato. You're quite the expert on the scooter. Looks like Pato is ready to show what an expert can do. Woohoo-wee! You really know how to handle that scooter, Pato. I like your caterpillar scooter, baby bird. Pato thinks you should stick to taking pictures of him, at least until you're bigger. Oh my, that does look impressive. Oh dear, I don't think Ellie's going to be happy about this. But Pato, that's Ellie's scooter. Pato's having too much fun to remember. Oh my goodness. Oh no! Oh, Pato, no! That was Ellie's scooter, remember, Pato?
Ellie!
Oh, whatever are you going to do? You really think Ellie will like your, sculpture as much as her scooter? Can any of you tell Pocoyo who's coming?
Ellie's coming.
Pato, is that you? Hello, Ellie. Ellie, maybe you shouldn't get on your scooter just this minute. Oh, Ellie! Oh, dear. You see, Ellie, your scooter is, broken. They'll get it fixed. Don't worry. They tried their best. Really, they did. You shouldn't hug them. You mean you're not angry that your scooter's broken? What's going on? Oh, I see. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what Ellie has there? Yeah, right. And quite a fancy scooter at that. Oh, dear. all that worry for nothing. Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for telling the truth! Bye-bye! See you soon! Oh, look! There are Pocoyo and Ellie. They're out for a ride. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Ellie. There's nothing like a relaxing ride on a nice day to make you feel wonderful and bring friends together. Oh my! It seems like Ellie and Pocoyo's relaxing little ride together is becoming a race. And there's Pato! But where's he going? Aha! There he is, I see. Pato wants Ellie and Pocoyo to have a real race. How exciting! Gather round, everyone. Ellie and Pocoyo are going to have a race to see who's faster. I think Pato wants to get things going. So what are you going to say to get the race started, Pato? Yes, you say ready, steady, and then what comes next, Pato? Oh dear, Pato can't remember what comes next. Can any of you help Pato to get the race started? Say it with me. Ready, steady, go! And they're off! Well done, isn't it thrilling? Pocoyo and Ellie are neck and neck. Oh, and I think they've woken Sleepy Bird. Oh, and look, it seems as though she wants to join the race as well. Although, it doesn't look like she can go very fast. It looks as though Ellie is taking the lead. Oh no, what bad luck! Ellie appears to be stuck in the sand. And there goes Pocoyo, leaving poor Ellie in the dust. I mean sand. Wait a moment. Looks like Ellie has an idea. What's she going to do? She's pulling herself out. Pull, Ellie, pull! She did it! And she's off again! Nice going, Pocoyo! You're way ahead! You're working up quite a sweat, aren't you? Oh my! This is very strange. What are you doing now, Pocoyo?
Ice cream.
You're eating an ice cream in the middle of the race? Well, I must say, you must be feeling pretty confident if you're eating ice cream. Oh, Ellie. Well, you'd better get going if you want to win the race, Pocoyo. Off again! Look at that Pocoyo go! Oh, and there's Sleepy Bird! Pocoyo and Ellie are neck and neck again! What a race! Oh no, what was that? It looks like the car and scooter have fallen apart and so close to the finish. Oh dear, how are Pocoyo and Ellie going to finish the race without a car or scooter? You know, I wonder if there's a way you might still be able to finish the race. Just think, Pocoyo. You have a bit that still works and Ellie, you have another bit. Is there a way you can make a new vehicle, Pocoyo? can any of you help Pocoyo and Ellie work out how they could make something new? Yes, if you put each of your pieces together, you can finish the race together in style. Look at that! Pocoyo and Ellie have made a caruta.
Yay!
Perfect! It appears that you both won the race together. Oh, well, actually, it seems that Sleepy Bird is the winner. Ah, I suppose it just goes to show. It's really not who gets to the finish line first that matters. The fun is all in how you get there. And with whom. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon.